Sounds Business presents exclusive interviews with celebrities. Music online magazine Moose Business.
Hello guys, and thank you for watching Moose Business. I'm Masood, and I'm here to demonstrate my project with Polish singer-songwriter and name that I've done back in 2014. We released this one on Andy Moore's Breaking the Silence CD under Armada Music. So I'm gonna play a preview and show you the tracks right now in this project. Okay, here we go. So as you see, the structure is not too complex. It's easy to understand. And I've grouped everything, not everything, but so many things. So I'm gonna tell you how did I do this. Okay, for the start, I'm gonna start with the kick drum. The kick drum, I use the Impulse device from the Ableton Live sound process here. And yeah, as you see the name of the in the back in this blow, it's my own kick that I've done that in 2012 before. So it's a pre-baked kick drum. And I'm gonna show you how did I do that right now here. So I'm gonna MIDI a low kick, maybe something like that. And then I'm gonna go to the instrument Impulse. Okay, now you see the Impulse. I'm gonna get a kick drum. I usually use the other packs to get some punchy, the mid-range kick drum, and just like this one. So I add it here, and then I'm gonna double it here. So duplicate it here. I have two. This one should be the maybe mid kick and the low kick. For the low kick, I should get Trudy Vengeance, maybe. Bass drums. Maybe this could work. Okay, then I'm gonna use the EQ3 for both of them. Now I'm gonna EQ it. So just like, oh, where's the clip? Insert clip. There's no insert clip. I don't know why. So I just duplicate it here. So I have the, okay. As you see, I killed the mid and high in the EQ3. And after that, I'm gonna do the opposite here. And because of the pull of these two, I'm gonna about the the frequency low, it's on 250. I'm gonna get it to maybe something like this to get the best divide, you know. There should be a hole here between these two. So something like this. I just do something like this, and maybe I could add some high kick. Okay. For the high, I'm gonna... I can't just find it right now. I'm gonna use this one. The mid. I'm gonna kill the mid. And maybe... something like this. So, I'm gonna put them all in the one group, like kick, and I'm gonna put the glue compressor. I only used this one because it's too fast and too punchy and just great. So now I get something good. So we should just level these. Maybe to get the best kick drum. So we had a kick drum right now, something like this that I've done before. So if you're gonna get the kick drum for yourself and just be yours, you can just do something like this and mix and combine so many kicks together and get the best kick you want. So I'm gonna delete this from the project right now. And you see the snare. I think I've done something on snare too, but I don't remember because it's for just 2 years ago. I don't really remember that. Yeah. I've done on this before because okay. So there's another snare here. It's gonna sound like this. And yeah, I usually use a snare noise. I use the sealant and I just make a noise snare just like this. And put it something like this. And about the clap pre, I use the pre-claps all the time. I just go to the Vengeance, maybe which one is good, maybe clap and snare. Okay, let's say this one. I don't use impulse or something like those devices here. I'm just gonna put it like a wave. And imagine that this is going to be your punch cue. If this is the punch cue, you're gonna put it right on the timeline that the snare is gonna perform. So if this is the punch, I'm gonna just put it here and delete the punch part, and just the pre-clap is gonna be here, and it's gonna sound like this. As you see, just the pre-clap, not the clap. So I'm gonna delete this too. I don't know what is it. Oh yeah, I put that before because yeah, okay, I was about to do this. This is the same clap. Yeah, I made that for the master class. Okay, I'm gonna delete this too. So I'm gonna go to the part hi-hats. It's 1, 2, 3, 4 hi-hat and shaker. So you're gonna hear the hi-hat, the normal hi-hat that you guys all use that every time. Of course, the velocity is so important, the velocity. And this is a loop. I didn't change that, I think. It's just a Vengeance loop that I like that. But the thing is, I actually panned both to get a stereo feel here. These two gonna feel each other and sounds like just one hi-hat. So the next one is a loop two, and the shaker that I performed, the velocity is like this, just like that. And I put them all in one actual group, so I can just solo them and get the same dynamic to this. So about the loops. Okay, this part is very interesting. You know, just gonna listen to it. I found a pack that it was about the glitches and clicks, and it was so good. I loved that a lot, and I put that in my project. But you see, this is a loop, okay? But I actually did something like this with all the loops. I usually do that to all my loops, something like this, and something like this, 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 and made them all together and okay, the right click here and push the consolidate. So this loop is mine and you cannot just hear that anywhere at all. So you can just put everything you want in a project, in a loop. You can add it, you can delete it, you can do everything you want, and you can even change the transpose, the volume here, and then you're gonna consolidate it and make it your own. So I'm gonna undo them all. And I did that to all these loops. You can hear them individually. And as you see here, I made these two stereo too. So I have a stereo feel here. The next one. Okay, I may delete the parts that my kick drum is playing to not conflict with the kick mid-range, to be matched more. So here is the loop number four. I might do the same for this one on the snares. Maybe this is the snare and this is the snare. Another one. Yeah, so the effects are pretty simple, I think. Why am I have a T-Rex here? Oh, it's empty, okay. I have a T-Rex empty here. I'm a genius. Okay, so, oh, about the noise. Okay, I have a group named Noise here, which is very interesting for myself too. Because I exported so many noises. Actually, I didn't export here because I used the sample pack. But everything you see here was like this before. And I changed them like this. I put them together. I made a groove out of it. So I consolidate them all, but the name will still get here, will be the same. So listen to it. You see, there's a groove here. If I'm gonna play the noise part with the kick drum, you see the groove. Now with the loops. Oh yeah. So you see the percussion here is a bit maybe different than the other songs, maybe because I use so many noises, I use so many clicks here, and there's a crunch in this music, you know? It's like a bone breaking. It's something, I don't know how to express my feeling here, but it's very crunchy, I think. That's why, because I use so many clicks and so many noises here to get the groove. So the next part is gonna be bass. I'm gonna tell you here, the bass part, the instruments I used here is pretty easy that you guys all have it. You guys silent. You guys have the contact, I don't know, a virus bass I used here, another bass here by Sealant. So it's not a big deal, but when you hear the tone of it, you're gonna curious what is happening here. Okay, listen to it. Okay, now individually. Okay, this is not something that gets together easily because I had to do something with it. So about the process, okay, I actually, if you see the notes, these two are the same, these two are the same, and this is the part that is an electro bass. Okay. So what did I do in this process? As you see, the EQ is here. I used the version 8 of Ableton Live. So in that time that I've done this, I didn't have the 9.1. So you see the low cut is like this, but I actually use the 4X pull all the time, which is this one. But as you see, all the project is done here like this. That means I was using the 8 version of the Ableton Live. So I did that and I put an EQ3 and killed the low part to get this, actually. To get this, I had to do this. But when now I have this, the 4X pull, then I don't have to do that anymore. So in this project, it's just like this. And there's an auto filter that I used somewhere like here. And the sidechain effect, the compressor, and the normal compressor. Okay, the thing is, I used a vocoder to get this sound here. As you can see, I'm gonna bypass and then I'm gonna enable it to let you know what is the difference between both of them. So I'm gonna bypass it right now. You see, so many frequencies are gone, and it sounds like something, it outstands the sound in comparing of the other songs maybe you heard before or I've done before, because I use this vocoder to do this this trick. This is a trick that I've done, that I lower the percentage of the depth to the 66%, and the foreman to -2.2, and 150 milliseconds for the release time here, and you see the difference right now. Yeah, this is the bass part. So I'm gonna go for the riff or the chords or anything you say. Well, as you see, I did the same here. I did the same trick to my riffs. So if I'm gonna bypass this, you're gonna hear it this way. You see, there are so many other frequencies in the original sound, but now all of them are gone, and it just stands out from the other sounds in the music that I've done. You're gonna hear it better maybe here. It's a silent let go preset. It's not a big deal. It's very simple. It's a preset that you guys all have it. And you see now? Yeah. And I use the Zeta from the Yamaha, I think. The Chord of Life preset, which is not a big deal. You see how the vocoder will change the sound all the time. And the notes. This is pretty simple. So here's the riff and the other parts. There's something here named group. It's the drone part, maybe the pads, the strings that I've done. Okay, about this, it's a wave, but it was a contact before, and I used Symphobia and LA string to get these sounds, and I played them, and because of my CPU usage, as you see here, I usually freeze so many things. The things that I know I'm not gonna change them at all, I will just freeze it and make a wave, flatten them and make the wave part to get the best performance on my system. So the next, this one was the string, and this is the pad. It's from the Nexus. It's gonna load. Oh God, okay. So it's the Big Tone Signature 7th Dimension, which is a pretty cool, and I used just a quick compressor on it and another compressor, and I look at everything here. So pad number 2 is a silent Anjuna pad. Pad 3 is more about the sounds, not the melody or something, the harmony or something. 2 arpeggiators, 3 actually arpeggiators here from the Nexus. Okay, this part is gonna sound like this. Thank you. Okay, the next part is gonna be something like a melody I've played here. And it is more about the delay, the ping pong delay I put in this one. And if I'm gonna bypass the delay, you're gonna hear it like this. Now with the delay. Yeah, sounds pretty cool right now with the delay option. And I use the auto filter and I automate it like this. And the sidechain compressor, two sidechain compressors. Okay, I'm gonna tell you why. And the normal compressor, two sidechain compressors because of the one of them, it's on the sidekick and another one is on the group 61. Okay, the group 61 is, group 61 is on the vocals, yeah. Because of the frequencies of this sound, it's gonna conflict with the frequencies on the vocals. So when the vocal start performing, this sound is gonna get compressed more. So you're not gonna hear that clearly. It's gonna get down. Because of the compressor, because of the vocals the performing. So here's a trick. You can just use the sidechain effect to mix many sounds in your music. When a singer is performing something, that means the singer is the top priority for your mix, that you're gonna hear the singer's voice upper than the other sounds in your music. So when you performing a hi-hat, it's a high frequency and it's not gonna conflict with your vocals in most of the time. But if you're playing something like this, that the frequency is gonna be, I'm gonna put something here to let you see. You see? It's around 1K, and the vocals is gonna be around here too. So, these bows are gonna overload the frequencies, overlap the frequencies, and it's gonna sound really bad. So I had to use a sidechain compressor with the vocals. Audio from the vocals, and when my vocals is performing, this sound's gonna get compressed and you're not hearing this sound clearly. It's gonna get down to the music. So that's the trick. I use this trick all the time, actually. I use that, yeah, all the time. For my radio show, I'm talking, the music get down, and when I finish talking, the music automatically is gonna get up. Yeah, the next part is the piano. I'm gonna solo to let you hear that. And it's the Alicia Keys contact that I have. I compressed it too much, I think, to get the sound that I want it to be. And Yeah, the next part is, oh, actually the river part. I heard the reverb, but I didn't know why I don't have the reverb device here. I used a send and return reverb here. So you can see the decay time is 6 seconds. And I cut the low frequencies. And I didn't do anything else in this reverb. Maybe pre-delay on 2.5 milliseconds. So I get this beautiful reverb, because it was like this, and after that I sent that to the reverb like this. So it sounds like a huge venue and piano player sitting there alone and playing for himself. Okay, the next part is real guitar. I performed a guitar that I freeze that because of my CPU situation. So I'm gonna show you how did I do that. So the real guitar is here. So I'm gonna get the chord. Okay, which one was that? Maybe the pick? No. Okay, I'm gonna put insert medical clip. Okay. Okay, let's say these four are your chords, and I'm gonna do the strum. What was that? Here are the strums. You can use the mute strums too, like this. So it sounds like the real guitar VST. So every producer hear this, say, "Oh, it's a real guitar." Okay, I know that sound. But what I do to get this sound, I'm gonna kill every low part, because it's a character of the real guitar VST here. Gonna put so many high notes, high frequencies, sorry. Now I'm gonna put put a glue compressor here, and so by this trick, no one's gonna know, or maybe someone get that. But so many people ask me which VST do you use for the for your guitar sound, and I usually say it's a real guitar VST from the Music Lab. So, but they always wonder how do I use that. This is how I use it. Now you can just put a saturator here to make it a bit warmer. Yeah, it sounds like a rock music guitar now. So that's it. That is pretty much it. How do I do that? So I'm gonna delete it. About the next part is gonna be the effects. This is not a no big deal actually. I didn't do many things here. Okay, the ad lib. The next part is the vocals. Yeah, this should be interesting. What I've done with the vocals here. The vocal part is the vocal part. The ad lib. I used. I usually cut something from the start and put it here, and I'm gonna zoom it out. I'm gonna find the part that doesn't, the pitch doesn't change very much. If I'm gonna put it from the start, wrong. It's the pitch is changing, but here, if I cut it from the here, it's not gonna change that much. It's just a straight note. So I'm gonna put so many reverb on it. Too much long reverb, and I'm gonna freeze it. Freezing the arrangement. Freezing. Now I'm gonna flatten. So yes. So I have a very long ad lib here. So I'm gonna easily reverse it. And oh, this is too long. You promised me the stars. Maybe that's that part. So it's gonna be something before your vocals are gonna perform. You're gonna put it there, and it for the ears of the listeners, they're gonna be ready to hear the vocals, and the vocals won't jump in just like a pool, you know. And it's gonna be a cool thing to do. I bet you guys know that. So the next part is chopped. I chopped the vocals. People usually ask me which device I use for chop the vocals. I don't usually use any devices for the chop. I actually use it myself. I just get some part of vocals like this. Just put it here and do something like this. I would get the straight notes, not the straight, not the other peachy vocals. You see? So I use that here and I put them together. I change the transpose on so many of them, and when I get the cool pattern I liked, then I just then I just consolidate them all here, and this is how I've done this. So I'm gonna play it. Yeah, pretty easy. Yeah, the other part chopped. Okay. The main vocals. What I've done on the main vocals is here. Yeah, I don't remember why I did this, but it's a chorus, so it's gonna get a wider sound. Paper thin. Maybe. Walls between. I use the art channel for the EQ and every sound. I don't know why I did this, but it's definitely because of the EQ here and the Ether, which is, I always use this plugin to my vocals, always paper thin, to get this and frequencies out or compress them somehow. The ping pong delay, paper thin, walls between us. So now you can see the chopped vocal here. What are they doing here? Paper thin. Walls between us. I have silenced every sound. You and my everything. Watch me win. Yeah. And I'm gonna enable them. This sidechain compressor on the vocals, of course. I usually do that, but not too much, just a bit. What are these? Just a radio effect that I mixed that with the auto pan, so it's gonna get automatically panned from the left to right, back and forth. So yeah, these two are just a homemade delay. Maybe sometimes I do this because I cannot get what I want from a device, you know, and I just do the delays. I just make the delays myself, just like the old times. So yeah, this is my project, and I'm gonna just play it a bit more. Thank you. Yeah, that's it. That is pretty much it. That was my project with a name in 2014. And I just explained that. If you have any further questions, you can just email me at info@masoudfouladi.com. And all my social medias are MASOUDFULADI. And I'm going to thank Moz Business for inviting me. I had a blast with those guys here and with you guys too. And I'm going to head out. Thank you very much. Have a great day. Bye.